Judo, you might know it from the Olympics, movies, TV, or even MMA.
And now we see him using those great grappling skills in reverse.
But despite being one of the most popular martial arts in the world, it is actually quite young compared to other traditional martial arts like karate and kung fu. So how was it, and when was it created? And how did it gain its status today? That's what we're going to find out in this video. If we want to talk about the history of judo, we first have to talk about its predecessor, jiu-jitsu. Jiu-jitsu is an unarmed combat system that focuses on strikes, submissions, and many more. The written history of jiu-jitsu first began during the Nara period, combining early forms of sumo and various Japanese martial arts. It was primarily used by the samurai to assist them in the battlefield, until in 1868, when Japan entered the Meiji era, the era when feudal society collapsed. The collapse of feudal society meant that the samurai was no longer needed, as they now have a proper military. This led to the fall of jiu-jitsu. Because of the modernization of combat, jiu-jitsu was considered obsolete and was taught to civilians instead of the military. One of the people who learned jiu-jitsu was Jigoro Kano. Kano was a small child who weighed only 90 pounds and was bullied a lot due to his size. Because of this, he started training in jiu-jitsu to protect himself. When Kano attended university, he started to look for jiu-jitsu teachers, which led him to Fukuda Hachinosuke, a bone setter who taught Tenjin Shinyo Ryu in a 10-mat room adjacent to his practice. 2 years after studying with Fukuda, Fukuda passed away. After Fukuda passed, he sought knowledge from different jiu-jitsu styles everywhere until he received his only verified training jiu-jitsu rank and teaching credential from Ikubo Tsunetoshi. After receiving this, he opened his own school called the Kodokan. The Kodokan was the first judo school ever, but in the early 1880s, there was no clear distinction between the style of Kodokan judo and other jiu-jitsu styles, until Ikubo Tsunetoshi came to Kano's classes 2 or 3 times a week to support Kano's teaching. Eventually, student and master began to exchange places, and Kano began to defeat Ikubo during randori. Usually, it had been him that threw me. Now, instead of being thrown, I was throwing him with increasing regularity. I could do this despite the fact that he was of the Kito Ryu school and was especially adept at throwing techniques. This apparently surprised him, and he was quite upset over it for quite a while. What I had done was quite unusual, but it was the result of my study of how to break the posture of the opponent. It was true that I had been studying the problem for quite some time, together with that of reading opponent's motion, but it was here that I first tried to apply thoroughly the principle of breaking the opponent's posture before moving in for the throw. I told Mr. Ikubo about this, explaining that the throw should be applied after one has broken the opponent's posture. Then he said to me, "This is right. I am afraid I have nothing more to teach you." Soon afterward, I was initiated in the mystery of Kito Ryu Jiu-Jitsu and received all his books and manuscripts of the school, Kano Jigoro, in reporting his discovery. To name his system, Kano revived a term that Terada Kanemon, the fifth headmaster of Kito Ryu, had adopted when he founded his own style, the Jikshin Ryu. Judo. The name combined the characters Ju, meaning the Lanzi, and Do, which is literally the way, but figuratively meaning method. Kano then divided techniques into 3 different categories, Nagewaza, Katamewaza, and Atemewaza.
But how did judo gain its national and international popularity? Well, in 1887, the Tokyo police organized a tournament which the Kodokan students dominate. Until Fusenryu students who were submission specialized start beating them, which make Kano invite Fusenryu students to the Kodokan for them to focus more on submission, and eventually some Kodokan students specialized in them, which led into the creation of Kusen Judo, which was not different style of judo but a different set of competition rules, which allow longer time on the ground. But back on the topic on how judo got its popularity, because of the tournament, the Kodokan gained hundreds of new students, which was remarkable because previously Kodokan only had fewer than a dozen students. In 1887, judo was also finally added to the national curriculum. But how did it spread internationally? Back then, many martial artists from other countries wanted to study at the Kodokan, such as Vasily Ostapkov, who eventually developed Sambo. Besides international students, many Kodokan students went abroad to the demonstration, such as Soshihiro Satake, Mitsuya Maeda, and Tomito Tsunejiro. During this demonstration, many boxer, catch wrestler often challenged judo practitioner, which judo practitioner won for most of the time. Professor Jigoro Kano also traveled frequently to other countries to open judo school and spread judo. In World War II, many GIs came home and passed on their knowledge for judo that they gained in the Pacific to other Americans, which it's also why America has a lot of judo practitioners.
Jigoro Kano has always wanted judo to be included in the Olympics, and in 1964, he finally got his wish, but he was unfortunately not able to witness it, as he passed away in 1938. In the 1964 Olympics, 72 male judokas competed in 4 different weight classes, which were lightweight, middleweight, heavyweight, and openweight. Throughout the years, the men's weight divisions changed drastically, and openweight was eventually removed. But it wasn't until the 1988 Summer Olympics when women were finally allowed to participate in the Judo Olympics as a demonstration sport, and eventually in 1992, women were finally allowed to actually compete in judo tournaments. But unfortunately, with it being an Olympic sport, meant a lot of rules were put into place, which restricted a lot of techniques, and this, according to some people, watered down the martial art. One of the most controversial rule changes was the partial ban of leg attacks in 2010 by the IJF, which eventually led to the ban of all leg attacks in 2013. According to multiple sources, these rule changes was because of the Olympic Committee not wanting judo to look too similar to freestyle wrestling and wanted it to be more exciting for the spectators. These rule changes made schools not teach a lot about the banned throws and submissions because they were always focused on the next tournament and sparring according to the new rule. A lot of people were unhappy with these new rules, which led to the creation of the International Freestyle Judo Alliance, which were under new AAU rules, which allowed a lot of banned techniques and was scored differently. But even with all the controversies, as a sport and martial art, judo is still very healthy, having as many as 50 million competitors, according to the IJF. People also learn judo to help them in MMA or self-defense. While many people think the martial art is being watered down, we think as long as people keep practicing it for MMA or self-defense, and not just for IJF competition, it will always be authentic and will not be going anywhere anytime soon.